What's going on, that's a day for you, my friends. Ever Air Gaming Geek Nerd Premiere is starting on episode of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild for the Wii U. On today, we are officially back on a Hateno Village, and we are officially on a Kuncho Sheikah Slate. But I've done some research around here in around Hateno Village, and right now, I want to go ahead and make a turf right about this edge where I see she asked me, Calvia, that the shrine is supposed to be pointing about this edge, so actually, I don't really want a shield. We might as well put a treasure stamp right about there. So, hopefully, I want to go ahead and knock onto that shrine because pretty much I have, not in the word about, moving to the next shrine destination, so I should be at least, we're gonna make, this section right about here. So, let's just try to go this way. And let's just go on ahead and see where it leads us to get to the Shadow Shrine. So, right now, let's just get on to it. So now, I just want to go ahead and pick up the pace because I pretty much not had the time to waste it. But you know why? We're gonna go ahead and continue on going. So now we have to go ahead and keep on hovering. So let's just get some more extra height by paragliding. And just to be sure, because I just want to keep two of my Revolver Gale ability, not even wasting two of it. So. Right now, let me see where we are now. So we have to go further this way. Yeah, we should at least go that way. So let's just see. So we can at least go this direction. That might as well take us somewhere nearby. And yeah, but we certainly need to go back to that snowy mountain falls where it leads us to another tree section. So right now, let's just go ahead and split ahead. And I will see you guys where I put the beach to the upper head of the tree. So. Right now, see you straight ahead. Okay, you guys, so this is it. So, pretty much we are back in here down below because you saw that down below where the treasure stamp is because right now you got a snowy trees around on your way. And further ado, this is the blocker that's definitely lit up towards all the rocks in our way. So, we might as well go ahead and get that shrine done because pretty much that is the Sheikah Slate map that I've written and not even looking hard enough. But right now, we might as well go ahead and throw a bomb and demolish it. And here you have it. So, this is the shrine that I was talking to you guys about. So, now on, we might as well go ahead and get that done. So, this is called the Hateno Uai Shrine. Okay, well, then let's just go ahead and get that shrine done. So we're going to examine, and then here we have it. So the secret, the setup is physically completed. So let's just go ahead and get that shrine done, and then we will move out ahead of our destination. So sound like a plan? Let's just get on to that. Now, at least I had to work on my pronouncing skills words, just making sure. Let's just go ahead and skip this already. And we saw because this is another easy shrine that I like to see in action. So let's go ahead and open this chest and see what's inside. So this here, we got the climbing boots. So it's only increased to increase 3. So it will boost you up by climbing speed up. Okay, cool. So it's saying right on the description. It said these rock climbing boots have special no slip toes that help you cling to walls. Okay, this agent technology facilitates more nimble climbing. Okay. So we might as well go on ahead and equip that. So let's go to our inventory and we'll go on ahead and equip that. So wait a minute, why? Increase up to 7? Okay, but I might as well go ahead and get that for a shot because that almost boosts up your speed to go on and climb. But I like to see that in confirmation, but I really love the fact. So now on, we just open awaken the shield by obtaining another spirit orb. So I believe we gotten at least 13 of the spirit orb. That's why I officially getting the point because pretty much the easy shrine to enter. So now let's just go on ahead and exit out of here. So man, we are just officially going all around Hyrule and knock it out, beating all the shrines around here because hopefully I don't even feel the experience of collecting all the, a lot more of the shrine. But right about now, we might as well stay on test of. Looking around to see where the shrines are at. So now there's a lot more shrine to be done. So now we are done. We're gonna go ahead and exit out of here. So right now that's already completed. We might as well go on and solving Kass quest again, and then we will go ahead and move on to the shrine of whatsoever it's called, the Spring of Power, because that's what we get stuck on. So now let me split that one more time. I will be seeing you back when I get on back-to-back episode of solving our cast quest. So, right now, see you guys straight ahead. Restless Cricket, a very energetic cricket. Cricket with monster particles, stamina, discover your life, sir. Pretty or two, okay? Well, we might as well save that in the future, because we're using that, but not right now. We're still moving ahead to our summon cast quest. So right now, I'm almost there, just quickly picking up the pace. So now on, see you ahead. All right, you guys, quick announcement, because pretty much this is where you split up. Split that right where we at. So now on, since you guys have seen the two range, because pretty much we're going to go in crouching, and there's a rain tucked underneath. So right now, we're going to go ahead and switch up with Eric for the day. And you want to get a perfect aim by aiming to that circle right up top. So we're going to go ahead and switch another arrow. I don't want to keep wasting bombers, but just arrows. So now on, we're going to go ahead and target fire. Actually, I need to get right aim. So we're going to aim it right about here. What would happen? Alright, I got to get a nice aim. Okay, that's too pretty soon. So now I have to aim it closely. Now I have to switch another bow. So hold on. So my bow is taking critical damage. So I don't want to waste another royal bow. So now on, let's go ahead and keep shooting bows. Got 9 of them, so I don't want to waste 9. Alright, come on. Don't waste arrows on me, buddy. Come on. So you want to make sure you shoot your arrows. Aim into the circle, but it's not physically working. But you know, I had to get it right. So can I stand up and do it? Let's try to do this. So I might as well aim it just about this edge. So let's try to do this. Alright, you know what? Let me go ahead and pick up some arrows. I don't officially have the time to waste too much arrows. So now on, I'll be right back in case I get the right aim or the target. So I need to quickly clear out the bows as usual. So now on, actually, you know what, let's just keep trying. So we're gonna stand back further right over the, this section over here, because these are the two rings that you need to go in there to lighten up the shrine, because right about now, this is pretty tricky. I don't like this idea. So now I might as well stand back a little bit. But I don't see the fat of how to reach it, so let's try to do this. Okay, I got it. There we go. So this is how I get stuck on this game, because right now I have officially unwaking another shrine, because that's pretty much what I got stuck on. So here you have it, ladies and gentlemen, right out the cutscene. So we have unwaking another shrine, and we're gonna go ahead and officially complete. So the shrine is already complete. So we're gonna go ahead and knock out this shrine fella right off the bat. So now on, let me go ahead and collect back my arrows. And hopefully, how much arrows do I got now? So let me check out my inventory. So I gotten, let me see, I'm looking at my camera because looking a little foggy dark today. So I got 10 already. So I don't know if I got 11, but you know what, let's go ahead and knock on the shrine already, okay? Shouldn't be too bad. So now on, we might as well go back to examine this shrine. And hopefully, let's go on and ahead and go down the bottom of the elevator of the shrine, and where it take us to see whatsoever puzzle what we are going ahead and solve. So remember now, let's just go on ahead into the bottom section of the shrine and see whatsoever we're doing now. So I believe this is another puzzle area over here, and we saw in these gates, because there's a spirit, this old wisdom fellow over here that's holding another guardian that we can't go through yet. So let's just take a look and see what sort of puzzle we are solving. So let's just try to see what this panel do. Okay, that thing rolls. Okay, and that thing like takes us down. So what are that keyhole chain supposed to do? Okay, so that activate the keychain, and I had to activate the another keychain right about the whole section. So right now, let me try to do it. So how we bring that thing down? Okay, so this platform, that guardian platform that I think we lit down. So we're gonna lit down right here. So that guardian spirit ball should lead right down to that keyhole chain. And here we have it. So the gate probably might open. So let's just see what happens. What? Are you kidding me right now? How is it not? Okay, well, you know what? Let's just go ahead and push it. So that thing doesn't seem to move down. So let's just try to roll it back down. And I have no suggestions. So I'm stuck down here. And I don't have no suggestions how to get up. So come on, seriously. Don't be seriously how not to at least you know, pop back up, because you need to stay down to that keyhole. So right now this is the I collect so far, the Great Thunder Blade. So that's pretty much I pick up from the wishes that fit these holes. So it decreased 12 to increase 32. So it's a durability positive. So right now it says this magic infused great sword was formed by the Hyrule's royal family using lightning from the Hyrule Hills, okay? Until when the blade glows gold into a spell lightning, okay? So pretty true. So I'd like to see that in action. So let's go ahead and place one right about this session. So I can quickly go ahead and get across. So now I have to wait until this seal platform looking guardian floating object that's leaping up in the up into the sky, because right about now I have to at least wait until I get up there. So alright, come on. Okay, so okay, we're waiting for that thing to lift up and to keep on moving towards me. Let's just talk about something like this, because I pretty much having a positive attitude of quickly playing this game because I've been doing pretty much well with it, because I'm pretty much happy about myself playing Breath of the Wild and trying harder to keep on playing this, because right now whenever I get stuck, that's okay. You type on a few things on YouTube about how you get stuck, what sort of shrine you are stuck on, because right about now I have a positive influence of knowing which way to do and figuring out around the box. So right about now, here we have it. So we are examining this mythical shield. So hopefully at least we get 14 of the spirit orb we quickly obtained, because we're saving our 14 spirit orb but not wasting anything, because we're gonna keep on saving a lot more spirit orb that we can eventually get, okay? So let's just keep that in mind. Instead of going on back to this the prayer statue, the mini statue that you can go ahead and pray some more the hearts or stamina, we're not gonna go ahead and do that. Because it may have one at the Kakariko Village that you can go ahead and fill up some more stamina and hearts. Yeah, they might as well have one of those. So hopefully we fit the beating the shrine. So now that's already complete. We're gonna go on ahead and try to move to the sprint of power. So that's where we're going ahead and move. So right about now, since we now had the dang rail scale, we might as well go on ahead and do this. So we're gonna go back to over here, that's to this Goron Death Mountain, whatever it's called. So we're gonna go on to Death Mountain. And it should lead us right out to where it's supposed to be leading at. So we should be at least looking at the map. So looking at the map right about now, we have to go straight to Elden Flank and see where the Dairail skill is. So right about now, let's just try to go ahead and place this mark. So we'll play a star right about there. A star right about there. We may not find it, because I think we disappointed myself in not knowing where I'm supposed to go. But you know what? Let's try to go ahead and split that cutscene and try to go ahead and find each and every one of the things that we don't miss. So right now, see you ahead. All right, you guys, we are back in Goron City, and right about now, I just split where we are because I don't really have the time to keep on splitting that way further too long, because right about now, we are waiting for the night, because I wasted one of my Vivali Gale and I had to be restored again. And right about now, I had to go on ahead and let's go ahead and keep climbing back up these mountains, rock hills. Rock cliffs. Sorry about that. And we should be getting moving along, because right about now, we definitely saw because of our train tracks that we need to go ahead and hop on. And according to our Sheikah Slave Belt, we have to go on and follow about. This guy's asking me to go on ahead and follow this section over there where the star is pointing. So we have to go further this way, because right about now, this is the spot where I'm almost forgetting the point, because right about now, my stamina is acting way too low. It's getting way too low now, so I need some more. Actually, let's go ahead and keep climbing back up, because we have a long journey ahead of us right now, because we have to go on ahead and keep boosting up. So come on, let's keep boosting up. I know we can make it, okay? Okay, just don't give up, Link. Just don't give up, buddy. Don't give up, buddy. Don't give up. Okay, you know what? Let's keep on climbing, okay? Pretty cool to waste how to climb. You climb up to your rock cliff, you get some extra height, and we should be on our way soon, because I see there's more of those that are red cheetah jelly. Because do I not take a picture of these guys? Oh, I already got the fire choo-choo. Okay, I don't really need another. So, now on, we saw there's more train tracks to go on. And right now, where should we go now? So, we should be following about this section. We should be heading this trail around here to Durania Lake. So, that's where we go on ahead. So, right now, let's try to be honest not to go fall down the lava, because it's pretty much too deep not to go ahead and get hot. So, now we're gonna go ahead and follow this, keep on running and charging to this bridge. And hopefully we might as well keep on picking up the pace soon. Right about now, let's just try to go ahead and do that. So now on, we still see, because we're inside this tunnel, and we saw there's another ultra-rock in our way that need to be defeated. So now let's just try to go ahead and stop it. So by the way, we can go ahead and pick up another ultra-rock part, and we might as well get a move on. Look at, man, still more ultra-rocks in this area? Okay, now get out of the way. Don't really need you right now. Don't need to be interrupted. So, hopefully we're gonna get a move on, because right about now, I'm gonna go ahead and keep on climbing back up through these rock cliffs as soon as possible. And we might as well continue going back to climbing, so let's just try to do that. So, we're gonna climb up to these rock cliffs, so let's just try to get some extra height, just to be sure. And we're gonna go on searching on finding that dragon, so the last dragon should be right about this edge, so we could be falling down here. So we're right here, we have to go for this session. So we saw we got a tower way further too far, and I cannot tell how to get through it. So right about now, we might as well go ahead and continue following the trail, and get me spot another shrine. We might as well go ahead and knock that shrine out too. So let's just try to be honest, man. Let's just get on exploring around and see what's where that dragon is. So let's just ignore these fiery keys, because they're getting annoying today, and I don't want to be paranoid right about now. So now on, let's just try to go on ahead and continue getting back to climbing. So we're gonna pick up the pace, and we're gonna ignore these fiery keys because they're getting interrupted, and I really don't want to be spotted. So please, fiery keys, go away, please. I don't really want to be followed, so now on, I really want you guys to leave me alone so I can go ahead and figure out what I'm supposed to do by not being interrupted. So, let's just start by following the trail, because I believe it's supposed to be pointing right about this sector over here. So, I believe that we have to go about this sector, okay? So, I'm going to get the search when I'm finding that dragon. So, let's just try to go ahead and keep exploring around Hyrule and see where it's at. So we might as well pick up the pace, because I don't have enough stamina to go a lot more faster as non-stop. So we saw, because what are we looking around? So I don't see there's not even a single shrine around here. Okay, so not even the bottom section. Okay, well, right about now, where are we going now? So okay, so let's go back down. I see we got there's some stones that we might as well go ahead and break. So let's go ahead and break some stone. We might as well go ahead and keep on breaking stones. But remember, guys, when you see we got there are luminous stones in the ground, you might as well keep on exploring ahead, because right about now, luminous stones are pretty much important in this game in case you're using one. So I'm gonna go use another, what can I go use? We'll go ahead and use the door spear. I don't know. And we'll go ahead and pick up some flint. Come on, let's go pick up everything we see. And now while we saw, we got still more of those stones we can go ahead and break. So let's go ahead and break up the rocks. And let's do the same thing. Come on, let's go ahead and keep poking with this spear, because I'm still using that weapon. I don't know how much critical damage it's going to take, because I don't want to keep on wasting this Zora spear. So now let's just go ahead and keep breaking it. Come on, so we'll get more flint. And I believe it's the last spot. Let's go ahead and get another luminous stone. And now we should at least keep on moving around the trail. So I believe that we have a long trail to go. So we have to keep on moving. So now on, it's supposed to be leading us to right where the spot that we need to be. So my revolver guild is almost about to take up critical restored. So now we might as well wait for that and see what the magic is happening. So we're going on ahead and take down this Ocelot. That's blocking our way. And we'll go ahead and ignore all these interrupting me. So what about now? Let's go ahead and
continue. Your volley scale is now ready.
Alright, thank you. Appreciate it for that. So now let's continue on moving up into the trail. So in our journey, we're gonna go ahead and run up and boost up way up for high up TV rock cliff. And we're gonna continue on along on running on charging above these rock cliffs. So let's try to go ahead and continue picking up the pace right about now, because we're staying on tests for the day. And we are not sure how to get up there. So this is Allen Flank. But I believe that we have to go to Allen Flank, or is it not there? I believe so. So let's just try to stay on grounds, because I believe you gotta be pointing about this section. So I believe that we have to go down here to see where the dragon is. So let's just try to see where it's at, because I had no suggestion. So it's 3:50 a.m. Not even a single dragon around here. Let's try to go ahead and see where he at, because we're still hunting that dragon and we don't see any suggestion where he is. So this guy asked me to wait until night because he's not physically there. We gotta be around these stones somewhere. So let's go ahead and use the body gale, and let's just try to take a look around and see where we have to go. So now we have to go on ahead and wait until he comes. So now let's try to go ahead and paraglide. We gotta see there's a lot more enemies down below. I don't have the time to mess around with, because I have to stay on test of finding whatsoever I'm looking for, because we need to stay on test for that. So let's just keep that in mind, because we're not going to be worrying about all these enemies that appear in my way. So I see that there are still three of them, and we don't have time to mess around with that. They could easily put up to the ground and then try to come and attack me. So man, how is it still morning? I need to be in night, because we're still hunting down that dragon. But it doesn't appear to be in morning, so let's try to go ahead and take a look around, because we need to find that dragon. So that dragon is supposed to be pointing above this section over here. So now we have to go ahead and keep on looking around and see where he at. So let's just try to be aware of where he at. So let's just take a look at our Sheikah Slate and see where we have to go. Alright, so what are we doing now? So we kind of like at least look on top. So there's the volcano I saw. Okay, so that's not up there. So actually, no, let me try to go up there. So if we go up top of this Divine Beast, let's just try to go ahead and travel up there so we can go ahead and take a look at the view. I guess we'll see how to find it. So now we're going to go ahead and teleport right about to the Divine Beast where it was. And then we might as well go ahead and view all around the Hyrule of looking in the lava world and take a look around and see wherever we have to find that dragon, because right about now we might as well stay on test and looking for it. So we know we can't go enter to the Viridania right about now, because hopefully we need to go ahead and stay on test of whatsoever what to do now. So we're in this volcano. We might as well go ahead and look around and see whatsoever that place is. So I see, because it doesn't look like a shrine to me. It looks like lava, of course. So right now, let's just try to do this. So this might be taking aim of climbing again on Hyrule Castle. Too dangerous to go near. Okay, what are you talking about? Okay. It's taking me back to where I am. Okay, so that explains everything. Well, I can't see the record of how to get there. So now let's try to go ahead and look around this Hyrule. And see what Sharan where to go. So I believe, let's just try to not go there, because I believe it's not there. So we have to stay down here. So I want to know what's down there anyway. Okay, so we're down here. So what are we going in here? Where do we go from there? Okay, so I believe it's the Abandoned North Mine. What if Abandoned North Mine would do something about that? Now, these are some sort of high Goron world that I'm not 15 because let me think of something real quick. So I believe because it gotta be pointing right about this section over here. So if we wait until night, we gotta at least go here. That's where the dragon is, right? Or at least go here. Let's try to put a stamp right about this section, okay? And we'll go on ahead and find out what's where to get there. So we might as well go ahead and get to looking for that. So let's just go back here. We're gonna wait until night, okay? I don't want morning. No more morning, okay? Okay, look, morning splash fast in the middle of the universe. But right now, you cannot tell because when it gets to night, it gets to morning. Well, what's the difference? You cannot see because the sky is going to keep on changing on back to morning or storm or raining day or cloudy or some show like that. Because I cannot see the fact of us information I'm getting on to with. But right now, we're still moving on back here. So, teleporting back to the shrine, we're gonna go ahead and wait until night because I don't wanna wait until morning because I got a lot more ruby to go ahead and spend until night. So, now on, let's just ignore the doctor while we're all trying to mess around with that fella. But wait, I'm gonna go in the wrong direction. I have to be going about this section. So, we might as well get a move on. So, I might as well run and sprint and keep up the pace. So, let's just try to go ahead and paraglide. So, we're back in the Goron City. So we might as well go ahead and at least go in down below and wait until night. Let's just go ahead and keep on looking around and see what story we're doing. So there's a place where we go ahead and sleep. So right now my stamina is moving slow. Come on, man. You gotta move faster than that. Let's just talk to him. So you tired? At least go on and laggy dag around and walking and talking to this old fella. So but now we're gonna go on ahead and keep on waiting until night again. And then we will at least... I think we see where the dragon is at because we don't know specifically where he is now. So now let me try to go ahead and split that one more time and go on and take a look where the dragon is. So right about now, see you ahead. Alright you guys, I'm pretty much taking a break of finding the dragon thing right now because I don't know where he is. But now on, I want to go ahead and knock on another shrine. That's way further down below in the bottom section because right now this is not a return of going back to Goron City right now. But this is what we I'm not even suggesting because now there's another shrine in down below. So let's just try to go ahead and see what sort of this shrine called. So this is we're in the gut cheat rock. So what about now? Brutal! Brutally rude, tiny hey hiding the scared platform. It's only for true Goron men and decided by the Goron. Blood breathers, so shove off, non-brother, if you want the spread, you gotta train hard to earn it. What are you talking about, dude? What are you talking, I can't go to another shrine? Pump it up, by the god I love my, me some muscle, this, right here is our hardcore training ground, strength beam. This is where we, come to, get ripped and shredded, it's where, Goron boy become Goron man, brother. Please move, right, leave it now. So, can you please, leave, move, please? I really appreciate it. I am moving muscle, brother! Not a single well, defined muscle. It's a special platform, secret, even only real Goron men have decided us free Goron blood brothers are allowed. Beside my littlest, bro is in the middle of training right now. Brother does not interrupt a brother's training, brother. But I gotta say, dude seem like a real man of action, almost like you have a grand air about ya. I like it. So what are you waiting for, brother? Get training. Yeah, that's it. You can clear our hardcore training program, I'll move out of your way. Come in, brother. Okay, ha, you're right, brother. We're gonna shred you to pieces, little man. Prepare to tell yourself. Okay, let me explain how this hardcore training works. The rules are dead simple. Simple as a deadlift, brother. Starting from the bottom, you gotta climb back up here within the time limit. Okay, but don't fool yourself into thinking it's only a climbing challenge, like, little man. You gotta pick up rubies as you go. Okay? You get up the cliff within the time limit and grab a passable number of rubies to your bat and you pass the test. Okay, if you run out of time or decided to give up halfway through the your climb, you'll have to return all the rubies you pick up. That's life, brother. We're gonna help you push back past your limits, brother. Your physical, mental, and emotional limits Okay, not messing around. It's time for the hardest of hardcore feats. Okay, well, guts challenge. Okay, so now we have the going to the guts challenge. So, oh, almost forgot a tiny detail, tiny man. No chain, no gain, and no pay to stay. So yeah, it's 20 rubies so per attempt. You want to some of this brother? Let's do this. So I'll explain the rules. No pay, no way. Sure, let's do this thing already. So right now you gotta collect 100 rubies as you climb. A hardcore Goron man sure will be able to handle that no problem. Okay, even if you reach the goal before time runs out, if you don't grab enough rubies, you fail. Don't fail, brother. Got it? Good. Then it's finally time for challenge. Go! All right, let's go then. I'll be quick about it. And not much have the time to be slow. So let's just do this then. So we have to collect 100 rubies. So let's try to climb really fast before the time limits. So we're gonna go ahead and grab all the rubies we can experience we get. So let's try to do that. And we'll go ahead and take a rest and break. So we're gonna go ahead and grab all the rubies we can. So let's try to go ahead and keep on grabbing all the rubies. So come on, if you don't get all the rubies, I might wanna go ahead and keep on getting more stamina. So let's try to go ahead and get all the blue rubies. Get the blue rubies. So let's get all the rubies we can. So we have to move a little bit much more faster because the time is given. So we have to move quicker because we got 2 hours remaining. So let's just try to go ahead and train harder than faster than the speed of sound. So I see there's 20 rubies we might as well go and collect. Come on, come on, hurry up. Come on, hurry up, Link. Pull the boost back up. Oh shoot, that's no good. That is not no good. Okay, you know why? I need to leave more stamina than that because I need a lot more stamina to do this hardcore training. But I don't have enough height to get all that stuff, but you know why? Yeah, this is the breaking spot. Let's go ahead and take a break. So we're gonna rest right here and we're gonna get back to climbing, so let's just be fast. Alright, I know we can do this. I know we can do this, come on. We're gonna work hard. We're gonna quickly get all the rubies. Alright, come on. Let's get this green ruby and let's get up back to climbing. So, come on. We're gonna at least take the blue rubies. So, come on. At least I can get more, a lot more rubies than that. So, let's decide if we can take a rest break. So, right about now, let's go ahead and collect all the rubies. So, man, this is a lot of climbing, man. I mean, for real, this is a lot of climbing. Yeah, we're going to need a lot more stamina because we don't have enough stamina to keep on climbing back up. So, I see there's a red ruby. I can go ahead and collect that because we got 50 minutes, so we got to hurry up. So, come on, how much ruby are we experiencing up? Okay, we got 20 rubies, so we need a lot more. So, come on, we got 40 minutes. So, we're not doing good. We're not speeding up the clock. That good. So I see there's a 5 ruby. Let's go collect that. Because man, I got 5 maximum stamina and I need at least a lot more. So I got at least how much? 90. Okay, I got 102. That's a lot. That's a lot of rubies. I can tell. We're almost up to 100 rubies. So I believe we beat the challenge. So well done. Well done, Link. I'm really proud of you. Let's keep it up. So we only got 9 minutes. 8 seconds. I mean, sorry, not 8 minutes. So we got 4 seconds, 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second, and we're done. So, huh? What do you think? You're doing, brother? You went over the time limit. I know it seems hard, but I can't let you keep a ruby that you didn't earn, man. What are you talking about? Talk about my muscle, minuscule friend, but I will be waiting if you want to take the challenge again. Don't let me down, okay, so, man, what are you talking about, dude? I just beat your challenge. Okay, well, you know why? See, because we're not doing pretty good at least, you know, like, experience a lot more ruby, because I want to go ahead and get some more of the stamina that I need to go on and do the challenge. So, you know why? Because we're not doing excellent today, and we're not doing a good effort and good deeds of spending much more time of raising so many of our stamina, so you know why? Let me try to go ahead and put a stressing point right about here. So we'll come back here later. We're gonna go ahead and put this on mark right about here. And sit, can we go back? I wanna go ahead back to Carco better to finally get on more of a stamina. So you know what, you guys? I will be right back because I wanna go ahead and get some more of the stamina and a lot more hearts. So be right back. Yeah, but nothing like a good stopping on place of going on a market and printing some more spirit orbs. So now, I might as well go and take some more stamina. Yes, let's go on ahead and waste all four of them because right about now, I need a lot more stamina that I can get. So, I don't want to go ahead and use all the hearts because I want to keep getting more stamina. So, right about now, we can obtain another stamina vessel. So, that would say our maximum is 6. So let's try the spirit more and hearts. So let's just get the hearts. So we'll save up 6 more. So we'll take one out of the heart container. So let's try to spin up more hearts and wise. So now here we have another heart container that can obtain us 10 already. So we have 10 of the hearts. So now we at least go ahead and take another last stamina and then we should be off. So now we almost waste 2 of the spirit orb today. So now we are taking another stamina. So now we're gonna go ahead and get back to traveling forward back to over here is whatsoever this place called. Okay, over here we're going back to the Gut Check Rock. So we'll be seeing you guys back there when I reach the higher course area to get to there. So right now, see you when I get there. Okay, so back on the top of the cliff, we are officially back to maximum of stamina to 7. So, right now, we're gonna go ahead and talk to this fellow over here. His name is Baggy. Whatever his name is. So I don't know what you're talking about. So right now, let's do this thing. So we'll get back to training, and we might as well not officially don't fail to go in and grab a lot more than 100 ruby, but we might as well go ahead and keep up the pace because there's a lot more ruby to collect, so we might as well go ahead and attain them all so we can get on the journey to the nether shrine. So now on, let's try to go ahead and complete the challenge. So here we go. So we're back here to grab all the ruby, so let's just hurry up because the time is speeding fly fast. So I don't believe that we don't have enough stamina to reach up to higher force. So let's just try to go ahead and get all the stamina reaching up a little bit more. So now we're just going ahead and sprinting. So let's just try to go ahead and sprint up some more because we got a lot of stamina, so we need to speed up. So we'll grab 5 and we'll keep on going. So let's just try to move a little bit quicker than speed cell. And we'll go ahead and keep on climbing. So let's just keep climbing. Keep on climbing, come on. We need enough strength. So come on. So we're gonna drop that down and then we'll get this ruby. And we're gonna keep on going back to climbing. So let's just go back to there. So we're going back to climbing, we're gonna get this 20 ruby. So come on, we need to hurry up because the time is being fly way too fast. No, not falling, no! Oh geez, well, I'm gonna fail because I'm just not gonna do any good. So you know why? I think I want to call off because I really want to start this all over because I just fall off the cliff and then I'm not doing pretty good at saving any rubies. Because come on, I need to move a lot faster because I don't have time for this. Okay, well, we're going to at least go ahead and grab that ruby. So we'll grab that, we'll grab one, and we'll get on back to climbing. So let's just try to do that. So we'll get 5 ruby of the spirit, 5 more. And then we'll get 20. Let's get 20. So we're gonna keep going back to climbing. So let's move quickly. Come on, man. Seriously. Well, why would Link ever want to fall like that? Let's get another resting spot because we're not moving fast. Because we need a lot more stamina than this. So right now, let's go ahead and keep on going back to climbing. Okay, so come on. Get the resting spot. Not crouching. So come on, we have to move. So come on, we can keep on going. But if we don't move faster, that's okay. We might well split again and keep on trying. So okay, we don't make it. Come on, we can make it. Come on, let's keep boosting up a little bit more. We need a lot more stamina than this, okay? We need a lot more stamina than this. So we collected 5. That's good. Because we need to hurry up because we have 20 minutes on the clock. So now I'm going to try to go ahead and report. So there we have it, you guys. This is it. So goal! That was glorious! Nice going, brother. Now let's see how many rubies you score. Look like you got 143 rubies? Unbelievable! You passed our training with the grit of a true Goron, my brother. In fact, you earned the right to call yourself the fourth Goron blood brother. I promise you are now allowed to stand on the separate platform of Goron manliness. Real honor, I know. You're officially one of us now, a true Goron brother. Brother, welcome to the family. And good news for brother, that means you can go do the gut check challenge all you want. Okay, the Goron brother, blood brother, you're ready for the hard stuff. Just let me know when you're pumped enough to try it. Okay, then, here we have it. So, we 50 completed the shrine, and now we are 50 going ahead and enter. So, about now, let's just go on and examine. Let's just skip this, skip already, and now here we have it. Because I knew that I was lucky enough to go on to the statue prey and pray a lot more stamina and one of the heart container we 50 obtained. And that's all I have, because now I just wasted a spirit orb to go ahead and pick up the first spirit orb we saw. So now let's go ahead and open the chest and see what's inside. So we collected here is a great frost blade. So it decreased 15 to increase 47. So it attacked plus 17 and up. So right now it says this magic infused great sword was forged by smelting ore found in the Habra Mountains permafrost. Attacked with a blade glowed blue to a spell freezing air. Okay, pretty true. I love to see the fat in action. So we'll put that in the inventory, and now we might as well go on ahead and knock on to his last shrine by obtaining another spirit orb. So let's just try to go ahead and unwaken this massive shield, and we might as well go on ahead and skip this cutscene. And over here, right after that, you obtain free of spirit orb. So I'm not doing pretty good on myself at saving a spirit orb for today. But we might as well keep that in handy because we're still saving up more spirit oil. Just to keep that in mind. So in the future, I might as well go back in the past or going ahead around because look at how much spirit oil, rubies we experience up. 6,022 rubies. That's pretty good. And I love to see it in fat and action because we're doing excellent, you guys. So right now, I believe that is it. So prove your grit, brother. So let's talk to this guy again. So pump it up, blood, brother. Okay, you clear our training program like it was nothing. But I know your type. Your type is my type. You can't be satisfied with just one victory. Can you, brother? To be a true Goron man, you gotta be unflinchingly dedicated to training. No flinching whatsoever. Lucky for you, I prepared a training program to help you ascend to even greater heights. I call it Super Gut Check Challenge! So, ready to take your training to the next level of hardcore, my brother? Nope. I think I'm done. I have nothing to train. So what? You don't want to train? I don't understand such thing, brother. Well, you change your mind. Come back. I'll be waiting for you to find your grit and raise right the challenge, little man. Okay, but we're not ready for another grit challenge whatsoever. I'm not saying, but you know what? We're done. So that'll be it, you guys. We'll be quickly picking up more exploring around Hyrule. And getting on back to find this dragon that we need to go on ahead and do on the next episode, you guys. So, thank you for taking the time to watch this. So, if you ever test enjoy the series, do not forget to leave an EVER-TASTIC like, share it to a friend, and subscribe. And become EVER-TASTIC active subscribers by getting a shout. If you want to get a shout right now, make sure we reach our goals up for 200 subs if you want to get that shout. And read the description, follow the 6 steps, help you get started the video, get you sharing the video to a friend. And link the description, follow me on Google and Twitter and Patreon. Much more support my channel if you guys have grown my channel and supported and participate and have much more fun of it as usual. And right about now, let's keep up with 12,000 views for people that are watching this. Making sure that we get a lot more people than 12,000 views for people that are becoming EVER-TASTIC and all. And if it's staying EVER-TASTIC added to my channel, I really want you guys to keep on doing that. So that'll be it, you guys. So we'll be picking up more in the next one. So, if you're new to my channel, if you are right now, do not forget to go on EVER-TASTIC to subscribe on my writing side, stay tuned on my recommendation videos, and go to my left hand side, want the last people episode of The Legend of Zelda Breath for the Wild. If you missed that, do not forget to go and check that one out. And we'll talk to you guys later on for more The Legend of Zelda Breath for the Wild. Take care, you guys, and we'll talk to you guys next episode.